So when I started in this industry 20 years ago, I found that my clients would very commonly come to me with a nutrient deficiency. I would often see yellowing from the bottom up. I would see yellowing in between the veins. And these are commonly related to calcium and nitrogen deficiencies. Calcium is a nitrogen fixer. So without the calcium, your plant is going to have a hard time taking up the nitrogen. A lot of these plants have very aggressive appetite for calcium. Also magnesium. As I said, when you notice that you have interveinal yellowing and the veins are staying green, that is a classic magnesium deficiency. It can show on new growth, it can show on mid growth, and it can show on lower growth, but most commonly upper growth. So I had a hard time dealing with these deficiencies until suppliers gave us calcium-magnesium additives. Products that typically contain calcium nitrate, magnesium sulfate, and a couple types of iron. The reason we have to put these additives in a separate container from our main food, or otherwise known as base food, which contains the main NPK which we are feeding our plants, is that if we try to put enough calcium in those main foods, we are going to see it bind up and lock out with other components of the main food. So we have to put it in a separate container, a calcium magnesium additive. So this is by far one of the most important additives that you can use. Not only will your plants veg better, stay that beautiful green, but when you get into the flowering process, you're gonna see fully developed flowers that have the proper density and hardness. So it's really one of the primary additives that a person will look at in vegetative growth and flowering. In conjunction with your typical flowering additives that blow up the flower size, this is going to fill them in and make them hard. So I would highly recommend looking towards a calcium magnesium additive. You do not want to wait till you are seeing these deficiencies before you apply something like this. You want to keep your plants always in an optimal state. Sometimes we use these products at about 5 mL per gallon. Sometimes we have to go up to 10 mL per gallon, depending on the strain. As I said, many plants out there have a huge appetite for calcium and magnesium. So make sure you give it to them so you can see the maximum yield you're looking for.